The foundation of Zoom IQ for Sales is the data that your team feeds into it. So before we can create indicators or integrate with a CRM, we must first start gathering data to analyze. Let's go. To begin, in a web browser, navigate to zoom.us and sign in to your Zoom account. Along the left navigation under Personal, expand Zoom IQ for Sales and select Users. If you don't see this menu option, it is because you aren't assigned to a role with the correct privileges for IQ for Sales. Shown here is every user that is assigned an IQ for Sales license, when they were provisioned their license, what role they are assigned, as well as any team they have been added to. To the right of this information are two columns of icons. These icons represent which services are capturing activity and feeding that data into IQ for Sales for that specific user. A gray icon indicates that a particular service has yet to be connected, but will turn blue once it is. This page is an excellent way to see, at a high level, which users are gathering data from which source and which users might need assistance. As an administrator, you can connect some of these services without user intervention, but let's go through what options are available for each. Along the left navigation under Admin, expand Account Management and select Account Settings. If you are an admin for other products, you may see additional tabs along the top. Be sure to select Zoom IQ for Sales. Here, broken neatly into sections, is where you can set the overarching account policies as they relate to IQ for Sales. The first section covers the sharing and editing permissions of conversations, which we are skipping past since our objective, for now, is data gathering. First up is meetings, and let's see those icons from earlier to help demonstrate the impact of each setting. Once anyone is assigned an IQ for Sales license, the first meetings icon will turn blue because the team member now has the ability to utilize IQ for Sales. When in a meeting, the option to record to the cloud with Zoom IQ is now available. If you toggle on the setting to automatically record scheduled meetings with external participants, the second meetings icon will turn blue as well. Be aware that in this state, users can disable this setting for themselves. However, by locking the setting, users will not be able to modify the setting. Quick detour. In order for the meeting's auto-record feature to work properly, IQ for Sales also needs access to your calendar, which we'll touch on shortly. Zoom IQ scans the attendees for each meeting to look at the extension of their email address. If an external party is detected, auto-record will be turned on for that meeting. So having your calendar configured with Zoom heavily impacts this process. If meetings auto record is enabled, be sure to dial in who this setting should impact, what should not be automatically recorded, how attendees are notified of the recording, and any exclusions to this policy. One other critical meetings setting is found in the Recordings tab of your account settings. Be sure to check the box to create audio transcript and consider locking it as well. The audio transcript helps identify different speakers during a conversation. If this setting wasn't enabled, you wouldn't be able to differentiate who is speaking, which can hamper other Zoom IQ features and reports. To analyze Zoom phone calls with IQ for Sales, toggle this setting on. Again, below this setting are more granular controls, allowing you to choose which types of calls to analyze and if there are any exclusions to this policy. To activate the auto record icon for Zoom Phone, you will need to navigate to the Zoom Phone tab within Account Settings and enable automatic call recording there. This feature is most often used in organizations that require all calls to be recorded for compliance reasons. Before enabling this setting, be sure that it is the right choice for you and your organization. Enabling ad hoc call recording gives users the flexibility to choose what calls should be recorded and which ones should not. You will want one of these two options enabled, otherwise no calls can be recorded, meaning no phone call data is being collected. The next icon confirms that a user has connected their calendar to Zoom. Each team member will need to navigate to their Zoom profile page, scroll to the bottom, and click to configure their calendar and contact service. The final icon confirms that a user has connected their email to Zoom. This is also a setting that each team member will need to configure on their own. When logged into their Zoom account, along the left navigation under Personal, select Settings. Select the Zoom IQ for Sales tab. Click on the Email section and toggle on Email Integration. To recap what we've covered, you now know how to check which team members are properly configured to capture and feed data into IQ for Sales. You also know where the specific settings are to enable and customize how Zoom IQ analyzes meetings, phone calls, calendar events, and emails. Now that data is being collected, be sure to set up those all-important indicators, which we cover in another video.